There are different lines of Kabirdas. Let it be foundation of peace, tolerance, and fraternity in the Middle East. Respected dignitaries all along the days, and the Augustonians, they designed it an honor to be the part of this National Law of Day 1990. The title of our paper is Bhakti Movement, the Unfinished Revolution. Friends, our country India, in the Bhakti period, witnessed a feudal society which was suffering from social, political, and cultural disorder. And Bhakti Movement played a prominent role in binding together the people of India into one harmonious core. And the beauty of the movement was that it wasn't restricted to a particular area, language, or followers of a particular religion. But yes, it emerged as a means of social change against the draconian caste system, sexism, ritualism, and untouchability prevalent at that point of time in the country. It aimed at promoting, preserving, and protecting the Indian womanhood as well as religious diversity in the estate of the history. This movement has drew its inspiration from Bhagavad Gita. The 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita gives us the lesson of Ekambika Dharma, which requires a person to believe in one and all Almighty and not his agents. If we look into the inception of the movement, in 6th century, from South India, the movement grew from a mere religious doctrine to a popular movement. Some brilliant Vaishnava scholars like Ramanuja, Nimbarka, and Vallabha gave philosophical justification for the concept and advocated for worshipping rites of Shudras in that period of time were treated as untouchables and not allowed to pay visit to the temples. If we take a look at torchbearers of the movement, we can see that they can divide it into Nirguna school and Shaguna school. Nirguna schools were one who were believing the Almighty to be formless, and Shagunas were the one who were not believing in the personality, but they were they were spreading the message of love and romance. Popular amongst the Shagunas were Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from Bengal, who traveled almost to all the parts of Deccan, Bihar, Bengal, and Odisha, and spread the message of humanity. Chaitanya renounced his worldly life at a very early age and became a sannyasi. And among the Nirgunas, it was Guru Nanak from Lahore. Presently Lahore is in Pakistan. So he also emerged as a heroic Nirguna, and he evolved the concept of langars, that is a common kitchen where people of all religions can come together and have dinner. Kabir Das from Varanasi, he also emerged as one of the Nirguna leaders, and he served as a common thread for unifying the Hindus and Muslims together. And the social events and discriminatory rituals suffered a death blow in the hands of the leaders. From here, my colleague Omi Shah will be enlightening you on this topic.
Thank you, Shiva. A very good afternoon, everyone. So till now, what we have seen is Bhakti movement is a social religious movement that came up as a platform to recognize the position of the marginalized sections. Well, needless to say, women also constituted a very considerable part of the marginalized section then. So, if we see the period prior to the Bhakti movement, the women's honor lied in giving women away in marriages. In marriage, even in the tender ages of 8 or 9, with a man who is almost 10 years of her age, and also she had to welcome death with her husband, the very popularly practiced known as Sati Pratha. The Bhakti movement attempted to bring a change in the lives of women. In other words, Bhakti movement, we can say that this movement had laid the roots of Indian feminism as it paved way for the women to take on qualities that the men were entitled to have. As such, renouncing their families and choosing the path of devotion towards their divine husbands. One of the well-known female doctors of that time was Mirabai, the one who had vowed to be Lord Krishna's wife since her childhood and had also refused to commit sati on the death of her husband. Not only an attempt to uplift women's social strata, the movement was also a death blow to the prevailing system of the society, that is the Varna system, as my friend has already said. Furthermore, the cultural enrichment of vernacular literature was another solid achievement of this very movement. Because the fact that the torchbearers of this movement opted to preach in the regional languages, attempted to make way for the other languages so that they can get a place in our constitution, and yes, today these languages are the modern languages and are recognized under the constitutional 8th schedule. So hence Bhakti movement, in the end I want to say that Bhakti movement was a socio-cultural movement which had a resonating influence upon our culture. And as the Bhakti saints taught us universal toleration, and but the disciples unfortunately opted for various sects and subsects out of personal biases, which goes to show that Bhakti movement hasn't ended yet.